Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Crafting Chaos with Melanie. I hope everybody's doing good today. Today's Sunday, and what we're going to do today is I'm going to do a fall share. I killed a paper pad. Not completely. I just have a few sheets left, but what I did was use a paper pad and the ephemera pack, and I want to show you what I come up with, and I've limited my supplies. I didn't bring any stamps in till the very end to see there were a few that I needed to stamp. I brought one ink color in, and that was it. That was it. I went for simple. I didn't pull any card sketches in. I literally tore all the paper out and just sat here and just put it together. That's all I did. And sometimes it's really, really satisfying and relaxing to just sit there and not worry about it. And the way Tracy says, Tracy, at Mindless Crafting, she always says it's mindless crafting, and she was right. And I really enjoyed the process. So my thought behind it was, on Sundays, I kind of like to get my desk cleaned and get ready for the week. So I have a little tote beside of me. It's a cube. It's, you know, the little square cubes you pull out of the cubed shelf. And it's full of fall stamps, and it's got some 6x6 paper pads and stuff in it. And I really want to use some of this stuff up. Now, in the coming weeks, actually, it will be week after next, the first week of October, I do have a couple of haul videos. And the reason I filmed those was because it was Christmas. And I did splurge this year for Christmas. I think I explained that earlier. I did that because last year I just didn't. You know, I wasn't in a great place last year. And I passed on a lot of paper and a lot of stamps, just a lot of stuff last year. I didn't do near as much creating as I normally do and what I've done the past 15 years. So this year, I was really in the mood, and I bought way too much paper. I'll be the first to admit it. But I did buy it, and I love it, and it's gorgeous. And I want you all to see it. That way, you know, if you want to run to Michael's and pick some up, I'll tell you, Michael's does have their Christmas paper pads out. And a lot of times you have to get these because they sell out. So anyway, the moral of the story is I'm going to be killing a lot of paper pads. And I thought it would be really cool to designate once a month in doing that. I'll come on once a month and just show you what I did. All right. So today, what did I do today? I pulled out Fall Sunshine by Not Too Shabby. I think I got this in a Not Too Shabby kit last year. Now, I limited my supplies, so I don't know about the stamp set. I can't remember. I'll be honest with you. I don't remember. I feel like I got a stamp set with this, but I'm not 100% sure. Maybe I just bought the paper pad. I'm not sure, but anyway. Fall Sunshine, and I love it because it is not traditional. It's yellow and black. That is your predominant colors, is yellow and black, and I would never gravitate to yellow and black. But I really like this. And here's the few sheets that I have. I have one full sheet left. And I'm okay with that because, as you see, the back is a black checkered. And I can use that anywhere. So I have the one sheet. Look how pretty that is. The mason jars. Then I have this sheet. And then I have a couple little pieces here. And I'll figure out something to do with it. I mean, for the most part, I'm very, very happy. And then I have the ephemera pack. And I don't know how many pieces was in this. It doesn't say. And I thought I used it all. And when I was cleaning up, I found a bird cage or a little birdhouse. And I was so upset. I thought I used it all. So I just kind of put that to the side. And I'll probably go back and just use the scraps and make a little tag or something. So I wanted to share with you what I did. Like I said, I didn't use any kind of, I guess you'd say inspiration on these. I just kind of sat down. I had something playing in the background, and I just started cutting. And whenever I want to play, when I cut, I normally just cut, you know, squares. If I have some circles on my desk, I'll use those. Whatever I see on my desk, I'll try to pull in. No sketches, no fancy cutting, just, you know, simple. Simple and quick and fun. So that's what we did. All right. So the first card, and they all differ. I'm going to put that one to the side. I'm going to talk about that one. They all differ. And I have thank you cards, I have fall cards, and I have happy birthday cards. And I love this for a thank you card. It's very simple. But I do have some wonderful customers, and I do like to send thank you cards, and I like to give thank you cards, especially around October and November. You know, you're in your grateful season, so I do that. And what I did is the little scraps that I had left, I cut banners, and I didn't do it in that one. Are you serious? I cut little banners, and I just decorated the inside on most of them. I guess I forgot a couple because this one doesn't have it. So this is just thank you so much. I didn't pull in any solid cardstock to mat with, which is out of character for me. I'm a big matter. I like to mat the different layers, but I held myself to not using anything but what was right here in front of me. So I have that thank you so much. Look at this birthday card. How beautiful. I love this birthday card. And I just put a couple of little banners on the inside. Isn't that pretty? And you know, the paper, you look at it and it looks so busy. But when you put it together, it looks really nice. There's another birthday card and just a little banner. Love this one. When I first cut this paper, I wasn't a fan of it. But when I put it together, I think it looks so pretty. And I love this. This will make a beautiful birthday card. And honestly, these birthday cards, any time of year, it doesn't have to be fall. These, any time of year on these. This is just a blessed card. And I have a couple of those. And see what I did here? I just used the little mason jar and the stripe. But on this one, when I was doing my sheet load earlier this month, I had some extra little half circles. So I just pulled it in. That's all I did. I had some little strips of paper left over from doing the faux shutter cards. And I just pulled it in. And we got this one, thankful. I just think these turned out so pretty. Blessed. Love this one. Many thanks. Look how pretty that is. I just had a square and I turned it to make it look like a diamond shape. This one's matted, but it's matted with paper that's in the paper pad. This was a background that I had on my table, so I just used it. It's got the little bird cage. And thank you so much. And let's see, this is fall blessings. Many thanks. Fall blessings. Now, this paper, I thought, what on earth am I going to do with this paper? It was just 1 6x6, and it was this. It was so bold. And here's the other one. There should be like three or four of these. They're so bold. But look, all I did was add a little strip of cardstock from the paper collection and put... And look how pretty that looks. It goes together. It really works together. It's so pretty. I did a friendly hello on this one. You could use that anytime. Well, that one's got pumpkins on it. You might want to use that in the fall months. Many thanks. Don't you just love that wagon? Thanks. Now, I'll tell you the stamps. I forgot to tell you that. This is a thank you stamp set from Heidi Swap. I've had this forever. So I just pulled that in and done different thanks. And then the happy birthday sentiment, it was laying on my desk and I don't have it right here. But it was just a sentiment from another stamp set. So I just stamped those out. But what I did first was I made all the cards first. And then I went back to see what I needed to add on the sentiments. Because some of them I didn't add anything. Happy birthday. Love this one. This is one of my favorites. And all I did was just put the paper together. Look at this one. Many thanks. They're so pretty. I just love these. Look, this, I took the banner down here. You could just write above it. This one is blank. All right. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I didn't even count them. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and I have one more, 19. This one is my favorite. And if you watched yesterday's video, this is the shutter technique, the faux shutter card that I showed you how to do. How pretty is that? How pretty is that? And I decorated the inside. So see what you can do. You don't have to get fancy. You don't have to have a lot of supplies. If you're new to this and you want to make some cards, then I will tell you a company that is so good about, you know, just putting stuff together is the Not Too Shabby Shop. It's Not Too Shabby. And she has a kit each month. I don't do the kit anymore, but every once in a while I'll pop in and get the paper and the ephemera packs. And the one that I have here left, I got one more left from last year. And this one is pumpkin marshmallow. And this is a slimline. So I plan on doing this one next. But look at this paper. This definitely does not have to be used for fall. Isn't this gorgeous? So all this paper, right? You get the paper pad and then you get the ephemera pack. And it all goes together. And you could sit down and just, you know, create cards to your heart's content. Have a little bit of glue, have some card bases, and there you go. So it's an easy way to sit down and mass produce cards. I love doing it. So maybe next time I might do a process video of it, like, you know, record me doing it and maybe just speed it up to some music. I don't know. I'm trying to learn how to do all that stuff. I think it's cool. I love doing that. I love watching that. So we'll see. Something else. Oh, yesterday's video, I did the mini thanks. I did the shutter card. And if I'm not mistaken, we did this one. This is what we did here. I'm making a mess, y'all. We did this one on camera. And when I got off, I did some more. And I just wanted to show you. Look how pretty these are. Again, this is a 6x6 sheet. This is a 6x6 paper pack from Catherine Pooler. And I could have very easily sat down and just did all these cards. And you could change it up. These are thank you cards that I'm going to be using. You could do birthday cards. You could do anything. But look how pretty this card is. And it looks so complicated. And it's not. It's so easy. All right. So, tomorrow, I think we're going to do the pumpkin. And when I say the pumpkin, I'm doing some rolled flowers. We still have the IOD mold video coming. I'm working on it. Like I said, that's turned into a bigger process than I anticipated. But I am working on those. And then we are going to be doing the mini album. Now, when I start the mini album, it will probably be the middle of the week towards the end, Wednesday, Thursday. When I start it, I'll show you the process, but when I start a mini album, my desk has to be clean. Like everything has to be up and cleaned. And the only thing on my desk is what I'm using for that mini album. It's how I do it. It works for me and I love doing it. So I thought I would finish these projects up and then finish up with the mini album and then the extravaganza on Saturday. So I can't believe this is winding down, guys. This has been so much fun. And I'll be honest with you, when I started September 1st, I really didn't know if I would be able to do this. I was a little worried. And honestly, I didn't know. I was like, you know, are you going to have the motivation to do it? Are you going to be able to create? Are you going to enjoy it? And I would say yes, 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 and yes. I have absolutely loved it. It has been trying. For instance, this is my second video today. I'm recording. It's 10 o'clock at night, I believe. And I've worked all day, so I'm a little tired. But I'm having fun. I'm having fun. So, yeah, this is cool. So, if you like the video, then just give me a like and a subscribe. If you're not a subscriber, I would love that. We are gearing up for another giveaway on September 30th. So how you enter the giveaway is leave a comment on the last 10 days of the month. So actually the 10 days, the 21st through the 30th. And I will pull a name out and we're going to have a big giveaway on that day. And yeah, I believe that's about it. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you got a little bit of inspiration. The products that I used, if she has these, I will link them, but I will definitely link the Not Too Shabby Shop down below. Like I said, this is from last year and I'm not sure if she has it, but I do know she has other collections. So if you're interested in just doing a quick card and getting dabbling in card making, this is an excellent way to do it. Okay, guys, until Monday, I hope y'all had a wonderful Sunday and a wonderful weekend, and we'll talk again on Monday. Until then, bye.